Problem number 5, add or subtract the radical expression. So we have the cube root of 64p to the fourth power plus the cube root of 27p. So as you may notice that these two terms are not like terms. So before we can add them, we're going to have to simplify each individual one to see if we can make them more alike. So first, let's split the cube root of 64p to the fourth into its perfect cube and its non-perfect. 64 is a perfect cube root, and then variables with exponents need to be divisible by the index, in this case 3. So we can split p to the fourth power into p to the third power, and then we would be left with one more p. Also, let's split the cube root of 27p into its perfect cube and its non-perfect cube. And 27 is a perfect cube root, but p is only 1, which is not divisible by 3, so it will go into its non-perfect cube root. Now we can take the cube roots of the perfect part, so the cube root of 64 would be 4, and the cube root of p to the third, remember you're dividing by the index, 3 divided by 3 is 1, so you are left with 1p, and then the cube root of p comes down. Now, taking the cube root of the perfect part of the second term, the cube root of 27 is 3, and again p does not have a perfect cube, so it just comes down. Now you need to realize that even though we simplified each radical expression, we still don't have like terms. In this term we have a p outside, but over here we don't. Only the cube root of p is the same, which means they are not like radicals. What we can do is, because they both have the cube root of p, we could factor out what they have in common. So let's factor out the cube root of p, and then we are left with 4p plus 3. We can also write the cube root of p at the end, because this is multiplication and multiplication is commutative, so you are allowed to switch these two parts, and I believe in the book as the correct answer is the 4p plus 3 first and then the cube root of p. So this would be your final answer for this problem, where this part is also correct. So it's just a preference of how you want to write it.